Meet Mike Kennedy. When he's not earning a living, repossessing multi-million dollar airplanes.
Looks like somebody's throwing a party for us.
Oh, put your hands out the side! Put that camera down!
Mike kicks off each day with his wife, Valerie. Some of the deadly critters he's rescued over the years. Like Spot, his 200-pound African leopard.
He jumped on my back and grabbed me by the neck. Sure, that gate's latched.
But like the other high-end repo men, most days begin with a phone call.
Hello.
Hey, Mike, I got something for you.
Oh, okay.
A bank has reached out.
It's a Lear 55.
A plane owner has fallen behind on payments.
It's going to be in the Orlando area sometime tomorrow.
If Mike accepts this job, he'll be hunting down a $1.25 million Lear jet, one of the first luxury liners to boast a wide-body cabin. The distinctive low-wing design ensures a stable aerodynamic flight and a desirably quieter cabin environment, despite the fact that it screams along at 520 miles an hour.
I know you're the guy to get the job done.
For Mike,
what's my take?
No matter how sexy the asset,
3%, huh?
Every mission has a bottom line.
Well, what the hell, that's 30 grand. Yeah, I'll do it, sure.
What the trick is, we need to get it back here in the next 24 hours because inspection status is gonna run out on.
Call you later tonight. Let me go ahead and get started.
Uh-oh. How long you think you'll be gone?
2 days.
Here we go again.
So how long is it gonna take you to give me a good walk around on this thing?
It's gonna take me about 2 or 3 hours.
Okay. Most. Well, I don't have 2 or 3 hours, so okay. I'm gonna have to abbreviate it. Just hit the essentials.
All right.
Brian wastes no time diving into a more thorough inspection.
He knows a lot more about what makes this thing tick than I do. I can fly it, but he can build it.
And I got some hydraulic fluid of some sort.
Mike, take a look at this, man.
What you got?
Brian's discovered a hydraulic leak.
See a little bit coming down there around that line. We need to take
it coming out this drain line over here?
Yeah, I think so.
Oh yeah, I see it dripping right there.
If the hydraulic system fails mid-flight, the pilot loses the landing gear, the brakes, the flaps, and the spoiler systems. In an emergency, a compressed air system blows down the landing gear. But without the flaps and spoiler systems, the pilot can't effectively decrease the speed of the plane on descent.
So what's up with the hydraulics?
I'm pretty sure it's the cap was loose and a little bit of hydraulic fluid trickled. All I want to do is tighten it up, clear the drain lines, and make sure that's what it is. And we should be in good shape.
How long is it going to take to fix that, you think?
Probably 10, 15 minutes, maybe 20 the most.
Okay. The sun's going to be up in an hour. I need to be long gone by then.
Brian races to fix the leak, but Mike is running out of time. 966 miles away, in Lake City, Florida, Mike Kennedy's mission to snag a $1.25 million Lear jet is nearly complete.
Glad Brian got that fixed this morning. We need to get the hell out of here.
With the hydraulic leak finally patched, Mike gives one last dummy check.
Okay, pitot's clean. Strobes, lights, ailerons are clean and free. The Jesus nut is there. Gear door's closed. Sure like to have a little bit more time to look at things closer, but we don't need an irate operator chasing us down the runway in a tug, so we gotta get the hell out of here. Bats on, inverters on, emergency battery on, beacon on, number one left starter, engage.
Brakes and steering,
check.
Y'all down?
Powered up.
A trusted co-pilot joins Mike for flight.
Fuel panel?
Checked and balanced.
Flight controls?
Free and correct.
Takeoff data?
Set on the left.
We gotta go.
Let's get out of here.
Mike Kennedy has successfully captured the $1.25 million Learjet.
Miami, yes, we'd like to declare an emergency. We need to get priority handling directed to the nearest airport, please.
But he's far from being out of harm's way.
Gotta go to the low hydraulic pressure checklist.
Before Mike can land, he has to quickly isolate the problem.
Okay, so we need to talk about extended landing distance.
No flap landing.
With no flaps, Mike will need nearly twice the distance to land the aircraft safely.
Pilot approach safely, PRF+20.
Pretty hairy and really, really fast. It's hard on tires, hard on brakes. No rest for the weary.
A normal descent for the Lear 55 is 120 knots. Mike will be coming in a little hot at 160.
Runway in sight, 1 Alpha Charlie.
Mike Kennedy sights the airstrip just 4 miles to the west.
This isn't good. Yeah, the gear motor doesn't seem to be working, so we're gonna have to blow the gear down.
With the limited hydraulic pressure he has left.
At this point, go ahead and unlock the emergency release lever.
Mike will have to use reserve air to blow the landing gear down.
And then ratchet it down. That should blow the gear down. There's one, two.
Down lights did not illuminate.
To make matters more interesting, Mike is unable to confirm if his landing gear is even down.
Hey, Jack.
Hey, Mike.
Yeah, we got some major issues going on here.
Mike calls down to a mechanic he knows at the airport.
It's like, got an electrical issue, but I've got left main gear. I've got no green light on, so I'm not certain it's down or not. I need to do a low pass pat the hangar there to see if it's down or not. I'll just come down runway 12 if you can take a look.
I'm going out right now.
Looks like we've got landing gear. All right, strap in tight, this could get rough. Another day at the office.
After burning through another one of his 9 lives.
Well, it's good to know they really were down and locked. Takes a lot more power to taxi to the ramp when the wheels aren't down.
Mike Kennedy successfully delivered the $1.25 million Learjet back to the bank. And for his troubles, made off with a $30,000 payday.